Hello and welcome to this program on Introduction to CAD. CAD, as you all know, means Computer Aided Design. In this age of globalization and cutthroat competition, design of components with speed, accuracy, and certain amount of standardization is of utmost importance. And the relevance of CAD today has taken a great significance. CAD, or Computer Aided Design, may broadly be defined as the use of computer systems to assist in the creation, modification, analysis, or optimization of a design. The computer system consists of both hardware and software. The hardware may be the computer itself, the graphics terminal, the keyboard, and any other available peripheral devices like plotter, printer, and so on. The software may be broadly computer programs, and application programs. Various application programs are now available in the industry, like AutoCAD, DraftPack, Geometrical Construction and Detailing, and so on, depending upon the requirement of the user. For computer aided design, a package that is commonly used is DraftPack. The purpose of this program is to introduce you into the applications of a CAD package and see how simply design can be done and improvement of the product subsequently. Let us see the essential features of DraftPack. Now, just like in all other computer packages or softwares that are available in the market, DraftPack is also used widely in industry and otherwise to create design of several different types of components. The applications of DraftPack are varied and depend upon the ingenuity of the user and the way he uses the program. We will divide this into two main parts. In the first part, we will just see a few simple basic commands that DraftPack can be used for. And in the second one, we'll go into some advanced commands. There are various simple commands like drawing of a line, a circle, an arc, and so on, which are all displayed in these buttons. Now, follow me as I move to the different buttons. I'm going to the first one, that is the drawing of a line. When I press this button, using the mouse that I am using, I get various kinds of lines that are available in the software. And they are broadly divided as three main types. Let us see the first one. When I press this button, follow me as I go down screen, you will see at the bottom of your screen it says the line from point. That is, I am supposed to give the starting point of the line. Say I give it here. Immediately, as this package is a user-friendly one, it asks me the two point, that is, the point where I want the line to end. And say I give it at this point. I've got a line so quickly. Unlike in conventional drawing, where it takes a long time to take your ruler or a scale and draw a line, in any CAD package or a drafting package for that matter, you can draw lines, circles, arcs in a matter of seconds. The second type of line available is this one. When I press this button, it asks me the from point. Now, using this button, I can draw three main types of lines: vertical, horizontal, and a line at an angle of 45 degrees. I give the starting point here. It asks me 2 point. If I give a point here, I get a horizontal line. If I move the cursor up, I get a vertical line. And if I move it somewhere in between, I get a line with an angle of 45 degrees. I want a line with an angle of 45 degrees. Here it is. Now, I want to move into a different type of function. Say I want to draw a circle. For this purpose, I do not want these lines to remain on the screen. So what I do is go to Modify, come down the pull down menu and look at Delete. Select Delete. It asks me which are the objects to be deleted. I give a window selection, move it widely, and my lines have disappeared. Now I go to the next type of command that is available, say a circle. You will be astounded to see that there are almost 6 different types of circles that I can draw. Now the first one is a circle with a center point and the radius only. It asks me for the center point. I give it here. Now it asks me for the radius of the circle. Say I give it here and I have a circle. The second type of circle is one with 3 points. When I mark the first point, I give it here, second point here, and third point here, and I have my circle. Now, for concentric circles, it says I can give a circle inside the circle or outside the circle as I wish, which is concentric to it. It asks me to select the circle. So I have selected this circle. It asks me to enter the radius. If I want a circle outside the given circle, I give it here. And I've got a concentric circle. Now let us see a different type of command. For this, we will delete the circles that are already on the screen. If I want to change the color of the next component that I draw, or the next line diagram that I draw, I go to Color and I select any color among all these various colors available on the screen. Say yellow. This color is changed into yellow. It means the next component that I draw would be of yellow color. I go to this button, which is to draw different kinds of arcs. These arc tools are 6 in number, 7 rather, and I choose the first type, that is an arc with 3 points given. I specify the start point. At the bottom of the screen, you get the command of what you're supposed to do next. So it asks me for the start point. I give the start point, I give the second point, and I give the third point, and I get an arc in yellow. Now say for example, I want to draw an ellipse, and I want an ellipse in green. I go to Color, select green, and then go to the command for ellipse. So I have to give the points for the ellipse. First point, and the second point, and I have my ellipse in green. Let me delete this. So we have seen some basic drawings like a line, a circle, an arc, and an ellipse. Now these can be drawn as quickly as possible and can be repeated by means of a mirror image or anything for that matter. And now we will see the next type of drawings, that is surface drawings. We have seen a few basic commands that are used in DraftPack, like line, circle, arc, and ellipse. We will now go into certain advanced commands. Say, for example, I draw a circle with a center and a radius as already seen, and I wish to dimension it. I go to drafting, I go to dimension, and I get 9 types of dimensioning. In this case, I choose this dimensioning. It asks me to select the circle which has to be dimensioned. I have selected the circle. It asks me for the dimension position. I have given that. It asks me for the value, say 10 units. I enter the value of 10 units and press the OK button. I get a dimensioning of 10 units outside the circle. Now, this can be standardized and can be used in all kinds of circles. Another command that I would like to get into is different surface types. Now, before that, let us delete the existing diagram on the screen. This, as you may know, is the x and the y coordinates which we will be using for our future commands. Let us now choose a different color, say green. Now, I wish to draw a surface. I go to the surface command and go to sphere. I want to generate a sphere of green color. The software asks me for the center of the sphere. I give the center here and it asks me for the radius of the sphere. I enter a value of say 10 units and I press OK. So, I get the surface of a sphere of 10 units in green color. Now, if I want to choose a different component, say a cone, and I want it in a color yellow, the package asks me for the base center of the cone. I give it here. Now, as I told you, we will be using the various axes. So, the system wants to know whether we want the cone along the x axis or along the y axis or along the z axis. I want an upright cone, so I choose along the y axis and press OK. It asks me to confirm the direction. Press the OK button. The base radius I give as I want to change the base radius that is already there. Say I give 10. The top radius is 0 of a cone and the height also is 10. I say OK and I get a sphere of base radius 10 and a height 10. In this way, various types of surfaces can be generated, like a cube, a cylinder, a cone, and various others. Let us delete this from the screen. Go to modify, go to delete. I select the objects to be deleted. I make a window and I have deleted the objects. Now, as a last item, let us just see modification in the sense of extrusion of a certain component. Say I choose the arc of a circle in yellow with 3 points, I get an arc. I wish to extrude this arc along the y axis, that is, I will take it around to get a 3D effect. For that purpose, I go to create command, I choose the extrusion command. I want a spiral extrusion, so I go down to spiral extrusion. It asks me to select the object that has to be extruded. I choose a window and select the object to be extruded. And the software asks me which along which axis I have to extrude it, X, Y or Z. I choose Y and say OK. And it asks me for the pitch of the spiral. I want to increase the pitch, say 10. The incremental angle for sections, I give an angle of 30. And the number of sections I give as, say, 75. And I press OK. What is happening at this point of time is that the computer is generating the arc in such a manner around the y-axis, so I get an extruded component in this manner. I have given the pitch, the angle and the number of sections. If I reduce the number of sections, I will get a smaller picture. If I give a greater angle, then I get a larger spiral like this. So depending upon the requirement of your component, I can vary the inputs and get the type of diagram that I want. For erasing that, I need not really select a window. I can just go to the component and say erase. Say or delete and go to the, give a single button for the delete of the whole component and the component gets deleted. In this way, as you can see, various kinds of diagrams can be drawn. They can be repeated, a mirror copy can be made, they can be altered according to requirement, various dimensions may be made and the diagram may be made according to the requirement. In various other packages, there is analysis which can be done of the component to see the effect of load on it, to see the effect of temperature and various other applications according to requirement of industry. This program is intended just to introduce you into the aspects of a particular package called DraftPack, and all other packages may be used like this according to requirement, so that design becomes a much more easier, a friendlier and an accurate thing to do. Thank you very much.